Hello, broadcasters. My name's Gage, and I'll be walking you through the green screen feature today. So first things first, why don't we just go ahead and turn it on so you can see what it looks like and how it works, and then we'll go through everything you need to know to make sure that you're set up to use it successfully. So if you just go to the settings, you'll see this new section titled green screen, and assuming you have a green screen, you'll be able to choose your own virtual background. We have a couple defaults here. You can also upload your own. Your guests will actually be able to use this as well. So if your guest has a green screen behind them, they will also be able to change their green screen in this section. So why don't I go ahead and select one of these virtual backgrounds. This is our brick background. We also have this nice home that you can place yourself inside of. Let's walk through the fade setting. So the fade basically controls the strength of your green screen. So if you turn it all the way down, you can see that there's no effect at all. If you turn it all the way up, you can see that I've disappeared completely. So you sort of want to find that sweet spot where it looks nice and crisp and looks best for your lighting and setup. Again, this is where having good lighting will help out a lot. And then you'll see finally there's the backdrop color. So if you have a blue screen, you of course want to change that option to blue. So now let's quickly walk through some of the things you need to know to be set up for success when using the green screen feature. So number one, you will need a green screen or a blue screen, and you'll want to make sure that it's a nice screen, no folds and tears or things like that. That will allow the green screen effect to look best. Lighting is also very important. I don't actually have amazing lighting, and it still looks pretty nice. But to get the best effect possible, you'll want to have uniform lighting where your entire green or blue screen is lit in the same way, and that will allow you to get the best effect. Then, of course, there's clothing. So if you're using a green screen, you don't want to wear any green clothes or else your clothes will also change into the virtual background, which you probably don't want. And if it's a blue screen, then, of course, it's blue clothes that you won't want to wear. The next thing to note is that more powerful computers will work better for this feature because it utilizes your computer's GPU. So if you have a graphics card, it'll be fantastic. That's sort of the best case scenario. Onboard graphics will also work. That's actually what I'm using right now. But the point is that the more powerful your computer, the better this feature will work for you. Next is browser configuration. Right now, only Chrome is supported. Most likely, you won't have to change anything at all, and Chrome will automatically be using your graphics. But if that is not the case, we have a long set of steps that make sure you have it enabled. I'll include that in the description, so make sure you just follow those steps if for whatever reason your browser is not using your GPU, but that's a pretty rare scenario. That concludes our green screen tutorial. If you guys have any questions, just reach out to us and we'll be happy to help you out. We really hope you enjoyed this feature. We really enjoyed creating it. Thanks for watching.